Hi, this is Penny, and in this lesson, we are going to review a property of light called refraction. Let's review a couple things we know about light. Light travels in rays that spread outward or radiate from a light source. And we also know that light can still move in straight lines even after it passes through a transparent or translucent material. And now, let's build on this and investigate what happens to light as it passes from one substance, or what we call a medium, into another. Have you ever seen a rainbow appear after a thunderstorm passes through? Rainbows are a beautiful phenomenon, and they highlight a really interesting property of light, refraction. The rainbow is caused by light bending or changing direction as it moves through drops of water in the air. What results is this beautiful band of colors in the sky. We'll look at the source of the colors in our next lesson. But for now, let's try to understand why light has this tendency to bend as it moves from one substance to another. In a vacuum, like space, there are very few particles, so light travels at about 300 million meters per second. I know this is kind of hard to wrap your head around, so put another way, if you were traveling at the speed of light, you would be able to travel around the world about 7.5 times in 1 second. But it's easy to be fast when there's nothing in your way. Imagine walking down an empty street. With no one in your way, you'd be able to make it from one end to the other pretty quickly. Now try to do the same thing with other people in your way. The same trip is going to take a lot longer. The same goes for light. It is impossible for light to maintain its super fast vacuum speed when particles are present. In fact, the more particles it encounters, the slower it gets, just like having more people in your way slows you down. Now you're probably asking yourself, how could this change in speed cause light to bend? Think of it like this. Imagine you're driving your car down a paved road. If you were to drive straight into this muddy field, you would just slow down, but your direction wouldn't change. Now try it again, but this time approach the muddy field at an angle. When the first front wheel hits the boundary between the road and the muddy surface, that tire will sink into the mud and slow down. The other three tires are still on the pavement and traveling at the original speed. With the outside tires traveling faster, this will actually cause your car to change its direction. The exact same thing happens to light as it moves from one medium to another at an angle, in this case, from air to glass. The incoming or incident ray moves in a straight line through the first medium, air, towards the boundary between the air and glass. When it strikes the boundary, the ray slows down because the particles in glass are more densely packed than they are in air. But once it enters the glass medium, the ray continues traveling in a straight line. As with reflection, we measure the angle of incidence, I, and the angle of refraction, R, against the normal, an imaginary line perpendicular to the boundary surface. How much the light refracts or bends is determined by how much the speed of light is changing. If it changes a little, you'll see a small bend. If it changes a lot, then you'll see a much bigger bend. Notice what happens as light moves through a glass prism. The ray of light starts in the first medium, air. It encounters the boundary between air and glass and bends toward the normal. This happens when light travels from a less dense medium to one that is more dense. Once in the glass, the ray again moves in a straight line. When it encounters the next boundary, this time between the glass and air, the light bends again, but this time away from the normal. This happens when light moves from a denser medium to one that is less dense. It's important to note that light only bends at the boundaries. Once in a medium, light will continue to travel in a straight line. This bending of light explains some odd phenomena that you've probably noticed before. Take this pencil, for example. It is completely straight, but appears bent at the water surface. But this is just refraction at work. The light coming off the pencil above the water travels through a single medium, air, before it reaches our eyes. The light reflected off the straw below the water has to travel through the water, then glass, then air. It is bent slightly at each boundary, and this causes the bottom of the pencil to appear detached from the top. This is actually a really easy demo to try at home. Simply fill a glass with water and drop in a pencil or a spoon, and you will see refraction. This can play some real tricks on you depending on your position. If you were looking down the length of the pencil, from above, instead of from the side, it can be a little harder to detect that light is being refracted because the pencil may actually appear straight. The light reflected off the end of the pencil will refract as it reaches the water-air boundary and bend away from the normal because it's moving from a dense medium to a less dense medium. But when we see a ray of light coming towards us, we always believe it is traveling in a straight line. So we perceive that the end of the pencil is further away and closer to the surface of the water than it really is. One animal that is able to overcome this trick of light is the osprey. This bird of prey hunts for fish, which aren't always where they appear to be under the water's surface due to the refraction of light in water. But the osprey is fully equipped to compensate for refraction and has incredible accuracy in predicting the actual location of its prey. And here's the big picture for this lesson. The speed of light can change depending on the medium it's traveling through. When light moves from one medium to another, its speed changes and light will bend or refract. The angle between the new path and the normal is called the angle of refraction, R. The size of the angle of refraction depends on the change in speed. A small change will produce a small angle of refraction, and a bigger change produces a bigger angle of refraction. When light moves from one medium to another denser medium, it will bend towards the normal. When light exits a denser medium into a less dense medium, it will bend away from the normal. Thanks for watching.